As you may be aware, there's a major trunk Nigeria gas pipeline spanning from all the way from the east, but specifically from around Port Harcourt, all the way across the country into Abuja, all the way to Kano. And then also you have another line that, you know, links the east to the west through what we call the Escravos Lagos pipeline, and then the OBOB3 pipeline. The connection of these three means that you can take gas from anywhere in the country and also deliver to the key consumption points. So those projects were delivered in pockets. They were not fully delivered until very, very recently. And some of them could not even make the progress that they should. For instance, the AKK pipeline, which is supposed to extend the gas pipeline from Jokuta all the way to Kaduna, to Abuja, Kano, into Kano, was practically abandoned. It's a project that's on the drawing board for about 10 years. And by God's grace and also by the sheer commitment of Mr. President, we were able to push that project forward, get all the necessary conditions precedents, including finding financing for it, the drive to make sure that it is deployed, and then getting the right contractors to move on site. And we were able to get Mr. President to launch that project even at the peak of the COVID-19 in July. And that project has not stopped for a moment, for a day. You know, it's continuing. We are going to deliver it. And in addition to that, there are a number of other infrastructure. It's very important to understand the infrastructure component of it before you come to the drive. The OBOB3 pipeline is supposed to deliver gas both into the AKK line and also into the lines leading to Lagos. They are all connected. So until you are able to deliver the OBOB3 line, you are not able to do this. And that also has been hanging for a long time. We are also able to deliver a bypass today. Gas has flown into that line and is running. We are going to commission this very soon. But more importantly, that's what we call the OBOB3 gas river crossing. That's a pipeline that is supposed to cross the river Niger to join the OBOB3 network. And that also has been hanging for a long time. We have also put a process by end of January, or latest by mid of February, we would have achieved this. What that would mean is that gas will be waiting for customers, not the other way around. Today, customers are waiting for gas. A number of customers were not able to satisfy today, including the major customer like the Dangote cement factory in Kogi State, and many other assets that we are not able to deliver full gas to because those infrastructures are not placed. So you have to push forward and put pressure on the infrastructure so that they are delivered, and all our infrastructure projects are now on course and are delivering. As you are doing this, you need to have a transition process, which is delivering LPG and CNG into homes, into factories, and into cars, the auto gas project. And this is also running perfectly well. There are a number of initiatives that are ongoing. There are a number of take-up points that we have established. We're engaging a number of critical partners to make sure that we're able to deliver CNG on trucks into certain key locations so that we have a virtual pipeline in place as we also progress with the pipeline network activity. The combination of this is we'll deliver gas into the domestic market. Even as we speak now, the utilization has gone to a level that we never expected because of the number of initiatives that are running. And specific to the gas project that we commissioned last week, it's actually a contributory project, just one project of many that we are trying to do. It's a major project because it will deliver about 240,000 tons of LPG into the domestic market, second to the NLNG, and also to deliver at least 100 million scope of gas into the pipeline network. So there are a number of such initiatives that NNPC is driving with our partners, and we have also seen significant interest from private players, including our partner companies, to make sure that we deliver gas into domestic market. One thing that has been a issue is pricing of gas. You know that investors are not CSR. Even NNPC does this so that we can make margin out of it, but more so for private companies. Private companies are more focused on the bottom line, which is to make sure that they make profit from it. And you can't do that except you are able to determine whether or not there's a pricing structure that supports investment. There's what we call the Nigerian Gas Expansion Program. Part of the activity is to have a very accessible pricing framework, which will enable people to see a line of sight around their investment, the money that they can make, and ultimately they can bring money on the table. So there are a number of initiatives going on. Many of them are very, very advanced. They're almost going out of pilot now because we have seen no hindrance to any of them. and ultimately those issues that you have referred to, what are we doing to make sure that this gas expansion project works is really work in progress, but there are no substantial progress.